is the last quartet of D. Shostakovich. My guy died in a sickly green room, in a bed with wheels. The chemo once entered her voice. Stay, Emerson. When it finally happened, her mouth was ajar and something came out mute. If only the doctor had warned her not to sing. I picked up her notes, hid them under all kinds of clutter from the attic. When the child from many years ago finally found me, pale and powdery as a shadow, I was sifting flour, passing a time of no more imagining. She was sitting on the edge of the sifter, striking a match, leaping down barefoot into the fire. In the underworld, they had their own currency, but the gilded paper still charred gray like all ashes. My grandmother's children, in foldable plastic chairs, dutifully carrying out the repeat sign of their elegy, hitting its heavy double bars over and over. Bit by bit, I lose the notes she and I once had. In this and that music, in this and that music, some dying person wrote, sick to the bone, to the heart. With diseases that had ways to kill. All of my notes gone, only diminuendos left. With nowhere to go, stepping on their own toes.
Thank you.
child. Uncross my legs. Unpainted my nails. Clip them so short, they're pink. So they won't still be so loud. I learned to unbang the keys. I wasn't sorry. Listen. Listen now. It's all very still. Not a sound of your slippers, of my home. I packed up my scene, my mess, and ran away with it. Yet there are still stories you choose not to tell. A time unwound onto its soft stomach, and everything in you, a sliding weight, steadily, evenly, cling onto my pendulum and swing. Thank you. Instructions on performing. She looked down, plucked out the one hair between knuckles of her big toe. Just another place to be hairless. She said nothing the first few times, then was persuaded to say yes, yes, and be quiet inside. Later, when she saw more of the world, she threw out her razor and spent time knitting her uterus into a hat. In some house somewhere, she would find that woman who gets too sad, who has gone mad, who is never quite right, who dies every night. So her tears drop onto the page hysterically. Silly her, what pity. Wearing her uterus on her head like this, like that, leaving like that, slamming the door like that. So brute and rude and loud. And when the composer heard it, she marked in her score, in fortissimo with fermata.
Thank you. Thank you.